started yet.
We still have not been able to determine how this fire started. I can tell you right now, we do have some fire crews that are still going inside the house doing a little bit of cleanup, and also with a notebook as well to determine where the potential starting points of this fire was. And we've also seen them spray parts of the back of the house as well with foam. I've asked, nobody is able to confirm the involvement, if any, of the person arrested here at the scene. I was able to talk with family, though, as they sat and watched decades worth of memories turn to ash.
Thank God, nobody was in the house.
The Bean family watched as fire crews removed burned pieces of furniture.
Slinging out furniture in the house.
The first reports were for flames shooting out of the house along Rockwood Drive around 1:45 Monday.
Bright part of the house and kind of worked its way down from what I'm seeing. When I pulled up, the house on this side was still on fire.
As firefighters put out the flames, the sheriff's office handcuffed one person, searched them, and took them away. A silver lining in the chaos. This moment, 17-year-old family pet Lady surviving the whole fire, hiding in the living room.
She was shaking and a little burnt, a little tore up. We had no idea she was still in the house. I've been here for 2 hours, so during the whole fire and during the whole putting it out, she was still in there.
Now reunited with her family.
And that moment of being able to reunite with Lady was a special one. I was able to watch it, and they're thankful. They also have six other dogs that are accounted for. All of them are okay. And again, as I mentioned, this right here is them spraying portions of the house that are still a little bit hot. Again, we do not know the involvement or the name of that individual arrested here at the scene or the cause of the fire. They're still going to be out here for several more minutes, maybe even more of an hour, this portion blocked off. But again, we're going to be staying on this and trying to find out more information about those involved. In Randolph County, Daniel Pierce, Fox 8 News.
Daniel, thanks.